Hello guys, and welcome to our today's video. Today we will see the conversion of gray code into its equivalent binary number in 8085 macroprocessor. Okay, in the previous videos we have seen the conversion from binary code to gray code for a single number and also for an array of numbers. So I hope you have watched out that video. If you have not, then make sure to watch out that video first and then come to this video. So the assembly language program of binary to gray code conversion was a bit simple, but gray code to binary code conversion requires 7 steps of calculations. So it is a bit complex than that method. Okay, so let's start by considering an example. Okay, let's consider a gray code number, let's say 1110 1101. Okay, this is gray code number, right? We need to convert this number into its equivalent binary number. So how we used to convert a gray code into binary code in binary arithmetic? First of all, we write this 1, then the answer is ZORed with the next bit. So 1 ZOR 1 is equals to 0, then 0 ZOR 1 is equals to 1, then 1 ZOR 0 equals to 1, then 1 ZOR 1 is equals to 0, again 0 ZOR 1 is equals to 1, right? Now 1 ZOR 0 is equals to 1 and 1 ZOR 1 is equals to 0. Let's say the number is here 0. Okay, so 1 ZOR 0 is equals to 1. Okay, I have considered 0 here so that it will be more easier to understand for you. Okay, so the concept will be very clear if you focus in this video. So as we have got, this is the equivalent binary number, right? So how we will convert the gray code into binary code in assembly language program? First of all, we will consider the number that we have, that is the gray number is 1110 1100. So we know this is the input and this is stored into the memory, right? That is HL register pair. Now we will rotate this data towards right. Alright, so this is RAR instruction. So on rotating it towards right, what we'll get? This one will come here, then this 0 will be here, then 110. Now this is RAR instruction, so the MSB will contain 0. Alright, now we will perform the ZOR operation between these two data. Make sure this is the content of memory and this is the rotated data. Alright, so we can say that, as we know, the rotate instruction is performed on the content of accumulator. So this is the content of accumulator. Now we will perform ZOR operation between these two data. So what we'll get? 0 ZOR 0 is 0 1 0 1 1 0 0 1. Okay, so this is the result after ZOR operation. Now again we will rotate this data towards right. Okay, so after rotating this, what we'll get? This 0 will be here, then 1 1 1 here, 0 1 1, and most significant bit will contain 0. Alright, now again we will perform the ZOR operation between these two data. Alright, so here we have got 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 1. So in total 7 times we need to perform rotate and ZOR operation. Okay, then after the 7th step we will get the equivalent binary code number. So this was the first step, this was the second. Now third time we will again rotate this data towards right. So this what we'll get? 0 0 1 1 1 0 1, and the most significant bit will be 0. Then again the ZOR operation, so it will be 0 0 1 1 1 1 0 1, right? This was the third step. Now again we will rotate this towards right, so it will be 0 0 0 0 and here 1 1 1 0. All right, then again the same ZOR operation, so it will be 0 1 0 0 1 1 0 1. Okay, then again this will be rotated towards right, so 5 times 0 and 111. and this was the fourth step. This is the fifth step. Then again the XOR operation. So it will be 1 0 1 0 1 1 0 1. All right, then again six time we will rotate this data. So it will be 6 times 0 1 1. All right, then again the XOR operation. So it will be 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1. Okay, now again we will rotate this data, so it will be 0 0 0 0 and last one. Then XOR operation. So this is the seventh step, that is the final step. Now what we'll get? 0 XOR 1 is 1 1 1 0 1 1 0 1. Okay, now we got this number as our answer. So this is the equivalent binary number. See what it is: 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 1. And what result we had in the first? See here, the answer is 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 1. So we have got the same answer. So this is how we will convert gray code into binary code. So what we did, we will rotate the content of accumulator, right? And then we will perform the XOR operation with the content of memory. And this step will be repeated 7 times. Okay, so one register will be initialized with the content 07 hex. And for 7 times, until the content of B becomes 0, we will perform the same rotation and XOR operations. Okay, so this was the concept. That's why I told in the beginning that this is a lengthy process. But if you understand this video carefully, then it will be clear to you. So now moving towards its ALP, first of all, what we'll do? We will input the data, right? So let's say the data is inputted from C050 hex address. Okay, and we will store it into the accumulator also. And as we have performed the steps 7 times, so we will initialize a register B with 7 hex. Then what we did, we performed the rotate write instruction on the content of accumulator. So this is the content of accumulator. We will perform RAR instruction. And then what we did is the XOR operation with the content of memory, right? And our memory contains this data, that is the content of accumulator in the first step. See, in all the steps we have performed the XOR operation with the content of memory. So this is XRA with the content of memory. So accumulator will be XORed with memory, right? So these two steps are the only steps repeated for 7 times, right? So after these two steps, what we will do is we will decrement the value of B, that is DCRB, right? And here we will need a loop to see whether B is equals to 0 or not. So for that we will use JNZ loop, right? And if the content of B is not equals to 0, so actually I have written here 1 2 3 4, right? This will be like 7 6 5 4 and so on. Okay, so this will go on decreasing, that is the content of B will go on decreasing. Now if the content of B is not equals to 0 after decrementing, then we will again perform the same operation, right? So from here the loop will go to this location, because here we have rotated the data, then again the XOR operation and so on, right? But if the content of B becomes 0, then what? That means we have got our answer, right? That means we have got our answer, right? So we will store that data into some memory location, let's say C051 hex address, and then halt. So its ALP is smaller, but its concept is a bit longer, right? As we have performed the XOR operations 7 times. You can also consider another example and check it by yourself. And that's how conversion from gray code to binary code occurs in 8085 microprocessor. So if you have understood this video, then please subscribe to our channel and hit the like button. And in the next video, we will see gray code to binary code conversion for an array of elements. So make sure to watch out the next videos also, and see you in the next video. Thank you.